Win now?
Yeah.
Is there like an action or something?
Yeah.
Hi, this is Burke Holland.
Sorry, this one.
Go now. Hey, this is Burke Holland.
And I'm Jen Abramoff.
And this is five things about React. Thing one. It's great, Burke. Thing one. React is a JavaScript library for building user interfaces. Created at Facebook by
Jordan Walk.
Some time ago, 2011, is that right?
So there was a library, like an internal library that Facebook was using at the time, called Bolt.js, and I think React kind of combined some Jordan's ideas with some of the APIs in Bolt just to make it feel familiar for Facebook developers. That was a long time ago.
Does Jordan still work on React?
No, Jordan doesn't work on React anymore. He's working on Reason, which is a functional language that's feels familiar to JavaScript developers, but is actually backed by OCaml.
So that would explain why he tweets about it all the time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Totally.
Oh, such luscious hair. I wish I had.
Oh, that too. Don't tease me about my baldness, Galnaz. You know how I feel about that. I don't like being bald. It's well known. Thing number two. The main idea behind React is components. What do we mean by components?
So you split UI into independent pieces that are declarative and stateful. And so every component specifies what it wants to render, and React takes care of actually using the platform APIs to update what's on the screen in response to that. Usually UIs have some inherent state, so like you might have a button that has that can be toggled, or you might have a text input that can change, or you might have a network fetch and the UI changes how it looks over time. And so React makes state a first-class concept. So you can declare what the UI should look like with a given state.
So everything is a component.
Everything is a component.
You're a component.
I'm not a component.
I'm a component.
No. No, that's not how it works.
Thing number three. Facebook now has over 30,000 React components in production.
Wow.
Is that right? 30,000?
That's scary.
That's a lot. Where are they all?
In the monorepo.
Just everywhere in Facebook?
Yeah, it's like there's a single repository and they're all there.
All the 30,000 components.
All the 30,000.
Growing every day.
Yes.
Excellent. Thing number four, if you're building React apps, you should probably use Redux, right?
No, you shouldn't.
No. Don't use Redux.
No, I mean, do whatever makes sense. I have an article called You Might Not Need Redux.
Wait, you wrote that article?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought somebody wrote it about
no,
you.
No, I wrote it. Because like everybody was like, use Redux. I said, no, wait, like, you're supposed to evaluate technical decisions before making them.
So thing number four is use Redux or don't use Redux. But either way, you should check out Dan's course on Egghead because it's excellent.
Yeah, thank you.
Why does this take forever? It's just right here, okay. Welcome. Number five, React Fibre. What is React Fibre?
It's a it was a code name for a project that we are shipping in React 16. So like we use the code name because we rewrote React from scratch for the 16 version, but with keeping the API intact.
Was
so
it like was it because you got bored?
Not exactly. It was because there were some fundamental restrictions in the old code base that were very hard to like. It was very hard to add features or change some things. It gave us some new features. And it also set up a foundation for like many other things that we want to experiment with this and the next year. So we rewrote React from scratch last year, and it still works.
It still works. When can we have it? Because I looked on the internet and it said it's ready and it's rolled out to all of Facebook.
Yeah.
But I don't have it.
You don't have it.
Is it because I'm not cool enough?
No, it's because, so I'm actually here for a week like with my team, and we're trying to fix the last issues that are preventing us from shipping it. But I think it's gonna ship in like 2 weeks, 3 weeks maybe.
So we're wasting your time right now with these videos when you could be getting React 5 out.
Yeah.
Sorry
but
about that.
I enjoy it. So.
Let me think how to transition to this segment.
Just a Twitter question.
Yeah, oh, that's a good idea. All right, let's do a question from Twitter. This question comes to us from Atanas Korchev, who asks, why does one still have to use class name versus class?
There is a boring technical reason. Do I need to say it?
Answer Korchev. He wants to know.
Class is a reserved name in JavaScript. And so it's actually pretty confusing that some code that you would expect to work, it just doesn't compile. So like if you try to destructure class is one of the props which people do, like const, curly, class, comma. So if you do this with class name, it works because it's the normal like identifier. But if you put class there, it breaks. And it's just weird. There are like small inconsistencies like this. And since React is mostly about like writing your own components, we feel that it's kind of important that it's easy to work with, like to accept props, to do something with them, to pass them down. And it felt like too much inconvenience, I guess. I don't know if that is helpful or not.
I mean, if that's the answer, that's the answer. I would say the only time that I find it to be tricky is when I'm copying and pasting code from places.
Yeah, but there are tools that, like, if you Google JSX to HTML to JSX converter, you can just do this automatically.
Oh, that's a good tip. You can also use find and replace, but
yeah. That's
a lot of extra work I don't want to do.
I don't know. I just press and hold Command D in Sublime. It selects everything, and then, like, type in it once.
Well, what you should probably do is submit a PR to change class to from class name to class, and then don't do that. I'm Burke Holland.
And I'm Dan Abramov.
And now you know five things about React.